One, two, three. Oh!
Sorry I'm late.
That's okay, we're having a boys' night.
Oh, what have I missed?
2 solid hours of rock, paper, scissors.
Wow.
I bet Daddy heaps on heaps.
Good boy. Mwah. Now, if you go upstairs and brush your teeth, I'll be upstairs in a minute to read you a story.
From a chapter book?
Sure.
He wanted to wait up till you got home.
Oh, so much for a family night. One of the nurses called in sick with a stomach bug, so I had to rearrange the roster.
No, that's okay. You're home in time for dinner.
What are we having?
Indian. I've already ordered.
How was work?
I felt like I'd grown another head.
That bad?
That's probably all in my mind.
Which one?
I'm going to take the morning off tomorrow.
Good.
Yeah, thought I'd drop Harry off at school and then fit in a round of golf.
Great. More time out is what you need.
Yeah.
Vanessa said it was hypoglycemia.
Who's Vanessa?
The doc. The one who beat you to it.
Right.
Just goes to show you never know when someone's going to need your help, eh?
Yeah, curse of being a doctor.
Bit of a drama, huh?
Yeah.
Oh, these stock market analysts, loaded and desperate to throw their cash around. I don't know how many bottles of champagne we've had.
Sounds like you're having a good time.
The best. Claire is such a good sport. Offered to come out, help me meet a few guys. Just my luck, they'll like her more than they like me.
Excuse me.
You mean?
Hey. You can save your money and the rest of your champagne because she is taken.
Baxter?
What are you doing?
I'm having fun.
What, with them?
Yes, as
and
a matter
why,
of
why, Claire, when you could be hanging out with me?
Oh, well, sorry, I didn't want to suffocate you.
Look, just because I want to hang out with other people, it doesn't mean that you're not the center of my world.
Well, Baxter, you've got a whole bar of people,
what
so hang out.
What is it going to take to get through to you?
I think that might do it. And my work here is done.
What about you?
What about me?
Go back and talk to those guys.
Well, they're good-looking, rich, well-dressed, and completely homosexual, both of them. Just don't tell Bex. Hey, guess who I ran into earlier?
Did he threaten to set the lawyers onto you as well? He's right, though. Breaching confidentiality could get us into a lot of trouble.
Ah, relax. Markson's just full of hot air. And all we've done is talk to Huya. Not that that's done us any good. I should have known she'd rather bury her head in the sand and put her hand out for the money.
Part of me thinks she's got the right idea, though.
And?
Now, don't panic. I'm not backing down. Just a small case of nerves.
Look, you know John Markson's just trying to scare us. And the fact that he's threatening legal action and trying to warn us off just proves that they have something to hide.
Okay, so what now?
Well, I feel like a latte myself. Well, we have to do something while we wait for the tirade of angry responses from our fellow researchers. You did send that file to the other MIAC centres, didn't you?
From an untraceable email address.
Watch out, James Bond. Hey, and, if you want out, I can take it from here.
No way. But we've done all we can do for now.
Yeah, but you look worried.
I'm just disappointed, that's all. I gave my all to Scott Spear. It sucks that it has to end like this.
You've done the right thing. And tomorrow morning, everyone will know that. And Scott Spear will have a lot more to worry about than you and me. Oh, I love a happy ending.
They're only in fairy tales.
So cynical.
I know a cure.
Guess I could go another. Hi there.
Hey yourself.
I saw you go over when that girl collapsed. Are you a doctor?
No, I'm a golfer.
Wow. Do you know Michael Campbell?
Yeah, he's my cousin.
The girls would love to meet a pro golfer. You should come join us.
Ooh, thanks anyway.
Oh, well, can't blame the girl for trying it. You lied.
Not exactly.
What, so you're related to Michael Campbell, are you?
Well, no, but I'm more golfer than doctor at the moment.
So that's what you want to do now, play golf.
Well, I don't really know what I want to do. I've got no idea.
At least you're still popular with the ladies.
Yeah, not the one I want.
The one you told me about in Rotorua. He's still pining after her. Oh, I'd like to know who she is, since she's held your attention for this long.
Yeah, I'd love to know how to forget about her and move on.
Single life ain't that bad.
Hey, Tarns. Have you got a radar or something?
Yeah, I've just arrived.
No, I picked up a bottle of wine on the way.
Yes, you can call me a mind reader.
Okay. I'll see you in a minute.
Hey, Richard.
Yeah?
I'm so glad you changed your mind.
Ditto. You made my night.
Too long in the bunkers, not on the green.
I've actually got a confession. I'm not a pro golfer.
Okay, here we go. You're going to tell me you're a parking warden.
I'm a doctor.
A doctor? See, when people lie about what they do, it's usually because it's something dull and boring. What kind of a doctor are you?
Well, I'd be happy to tell you over dinner. Tomorrow night.
Did you just ask me on a date?
Pretty smooth, huh?
Thanks. But I'll have to say no.
Oh, something I said.
You're very sweet.
Oh, you're Bailey. At least spend the night here.
I can't. What a big day tomorrow.
Work?
Wedding.
Ah, you know, weddings can be lonely when you're single. Need a date?
I kind of already got one. He's called the groom.
You're getting married tomorrow?
I thought I mentioned it was my hen's night.
Yeah, you said it was a hen's night.
If it makes you feel any better, that was the best last night of singledom ever. Thanks.
Walk from the car to the door.
Oh my God.